there was a man named Eben Byer, a successful businessman with a remarkable reputation in society. During that time, a strange new discovery emerged, radium. People believed it was a magical cure for every ailment, from headaches to serious diseases. Ads for health drinks containing radium spread, and people were buying them in astonishing quantities, hoping they would boost their energy and provide extraordinary vitality. Eben, always interested in new and unconventional things, thought he'd give radium a try. "If this makes me feel better, why not?" he told himself. He bought a large bottle of radium-infused drink and began consuming it daily. At first, he felt significantly better, more energetic and stronger. He even told people that radium was a miracle, claiming it kept him in peak condition. A few weeks into his steady consumption of the radioactive water, Eben began noticing strange sensations in his body, but he didn't pay much attention. Initially, his jaw felt a bit heavy, as if it were tightening or cramping. Soon after, he started experiencing a peculiar pain in his jaw, but he dismissed it as nothing more than a headache or fatigue from overworking. As days passed, the pain in his jaw grew intense, to the point where he could barely open his mouth. Each time he tried to eat or speak, the pain intensified. Then one day, while staring at himself in the bathroom mirror, he felt something terrifying. His jaw was starting to disintegrate. The skin around it was deteriorating, and his bones were becoming exposed. Eben stood frozen in horror, unable to believe what was happening. His jaw was literally falling apart, his teeth dropping one after the other, and his face was collapsing. He tried to gather himself, reaching with trembling hands to catch his fallen teeth, but his body wouldn't cooperate. He could no longer scream or even speak. The sight in the mirror was a nightmare beyond what he could bear. In that moment, Eben realized that the radium he had been drinking wasn't a magical cure. It was poison, destroying his body from within. He became like a walking corpse, his body decomposing at a painfully slow pace. Day after day, pieces of him fell away, and he felt as though he was dying a slow, silent death. After enduring endless days of agony and torment, Eben vanished from sight. People around his house noticed his absence for a long time, and the house itself grew abandoned. A strange smell began to emanate from the home, prompting neighbors to call the police. When they arrived, they broke down the door and entered the house. The scene before them was a true nightmare. Eben was sitting in a corner of his room, his body almost entirely decayed. His skin and bones were exposed, with no trace of human features left. The stench of death filled the air, and the sight was so horrifying that some officers couldn't bear to keep looking. The people living in the area thought the story ended with Eben's death, that the horror was over. But they were wrong. Shortly after his passing, strange things began happening around the house. Some claimed they saw a ghostly figure walking the streets at night, faceless. The shadowy figure moved slowly and always stopped in front of Eben's house, as if it couldn't leave the place. Neighbors recounted hearing heavy footsteps at night, the sound of someone groaning in pain, screaming. But when they looked out their windows, all they could see was the shadow. One night, a neighbor saw the ghost standing right outside his home. Suddenly, it disappeared. When he tried telling others about what he'd seen, no one believed him. Eben's house became completely abandoned. No one dared go near it, and those who tried would return terrified. Rumors spread that Eben's tormented spirit, destroyed by the radium, still lingered in that house, waiting for anyone to come close so it could drag them into the same fate. People became afraid to even pass by the house at night. Those who did claim to hear moans and cries coming from within. Beware. Not everything you hear about is safe. Some things bring death. Eben Byer was just the beginning. Who knows what could happen if someone else decides to try?